Imagination Studio presents Katie Kazoo's Switcheroo, Books 3 and 4, by Nancy Krulik. Read for you by Anne Bobby. Oh, Baby. Chapter 1.
So what did you do this weekend?
Jeremy Fox asked his best friend, Katie Carew. Katie, Jeremy, and Katie's other best friend, Suzanne Locke, were all standing in the schoolyard on Monday morning. I taught Pepper to roll over, Katie answered. Pepper was Katie's brown and white cocker spaniel.
Can he do it? Jeremy asked.
Yeah, Pepper's real smart, Katie told him. You just have to give him a treat, and he'll do any trick.
Maybe I should try that with Heather, Suzanne said.
Heather was Suzanne's three-month-old sister. She's been trying for days to roll over. She gets as far as her side, and then she flops back down again.
Jeremy laughed.
I guess that means Katie's dog is smarter than your sister, he said.
Suzanne gave Jeremy a dirty look. Then she turned to Katie and smiled brightly.
I had the coolest weekend, she said.
Katie choked back a giggle. Suzanne said the same thing every Monday morning.
What did you do? She asked her. I went to the mall with my dad, Suzanne told her. You know what that means.
It means you got whatever you wanted, Jeremy said.
Suzanne nodded.
Exactly. That's how it always is with my dad. When he gets into a buying mood, he just shops, shops, shops.
My dad never gets in a buying mood, Katie sighed. He hates shopping.
Mine too, Jeremy agreed. But I don't like to shop either, so it's okay.
What did you get at the mall? Katie asked Suzanne. Suzanne pointed to her t-shirt. It was white with a big American flag in the middle. The stars were all made of glitter.
I got this shirt. I also got the new Bayside Boys CD. It's called We're Back.
You're so lucky, Katie exclaimed. That CD just came out.
I'll bet you're the first one in school to get it.
Suzanne smiled broadly.
Gee, you think so?
So is it any good? Jeremy asked her.
Oh, yeah, Suzanne exclaimed. Even better than the first Bayside Boys CD. I was dancing around my room all day yesterday.
Jeremy nodded.
I heard the new song on the radio. They're a pretty good group, he agreed.
Suzanne stared at him with surprise.
Pretty good? She demanded. They're not pretty good. They're the best.
I don't know about that, Jeremy said.
Well, I do, Suzanne argued. They're the greatest group in the whole world. Don't you think so, Katie?
Katie twirled a lock of her red hair around her finger nervously. She hated it when her two best friends disagreed. It always left her stuck in the middle. No matter what she said, someone would be mad.
I like them a lot, Katie told Suzanne finally.
At least I liked their first CD. I haven't heard this one yet.
It's great, Suzanne assured her. I think everyone should get it. In fact,
Suzanne stopped in the middle of her sentence and smiled at Jeremy.
Are all of the articles for this week's 3A Times written yet? She asked.
Jeremy was the editor of the 3A Times, the class newspaper. He was the one who asked people to write articles.
Not yet, Jeremy told Suzanne.
Good, Suzanne declared. I want to write about the new Bayside Boys CD. I want to tell everyone how great it is.
Jeremy pulled a small black notebook from his bag. He pushed his wire glasses up on his nose and looked at a list of articles.
Okay, he told Suzanne finally. I have room for one more story.
Great, Suzanne exclaimed. I'll get started tonight.
As Jeremy put away his notebook, their teacher, Mrs. Dirkman, blew a loud whistle.
Class 3A, line up, she called out across the playground.
Chapter 2.
Hey there, Katie Kazoo,
George Brennan said as he walked past her into the classroom. Katie smiled. Katie Kazoo was the nickname George had given her. When he had first started calling her that, it made her kind of mad. But now she liked being Katie Kazoo.
It sounded cool. "Hi, George," she said.
"So do you know what the rug said to the floor?" George asked Katie.
Katie laughed. That would have seemed like a weird question from anyone else, but Katie knew it was just one of George's jokes. George loved to tell jokes.
"No, what did the rug say to the floor?" Katie asked.
"I've got you covered," George exclaimed.
He laughed at his own joke. Katie laughed too.
"If you like that one, you'll love this one," George continued. "What did one cucumber say to the other cucumber?"
"What?" Katie said.
"If you'd kept your mouth shut, we wouldn't be in this pickle," George told her.
Katie giggled harder. That one was really funny.
"Katie, please find your seat," Mrs. Dirkman interrupted.
Katie blushed. Quickly, she scrambled to her desk. George began to head over toward his desk, too, but Mrs. Dirkman blocked his path.
"You don't need to sit down, George," Mrs. Dirkman said.
"I don't?"
George asked. Mrs. Dirkman shook her head.
"Since you're so interested in speaking during class, you can go to the front of the room and give your current events report."
Usually, George hated when it was his turn to talk about current events. But today, he grinned as he pulled a newspaper article from his binder.
"My article is about the movie Tornado," he told the class.
Before he could say another word, Mrs. Dirkman interrupted him.
"That's not really current events, George," she said.
George looked very sad, so sad that Mrs. Dirkman said,
"Well, why don't you tell us about it anyway?"
George smiled brightly.
"Tornado just opened this weekend," he began. "It earned almost $75 million in ticket sales. That's a lot of money. A lot of people think that it could be the biggest selling movie of all time. They think it could win a lot of awards, too. All those people are right. Tornado is a great movie. I should know. I saw it with Kevin on Saturday."
Wow. Everyone stared at George and Kevin. It was hard to believe they had been brave enough to go see Tornado. The ads on TV looked really scary.
"Any questions?" George asked.
You were always supposed to ask for questions at the end of your current events report. "Was the movie as scary as it looks on TV?" Mandy Banks asked.
"Scarier," George said proudly.
"Did your parents take you to see it?" Miriam Chan wondered.
"Nope, Kevin's big brother Ian took us," George said.
"Did you sit through the whole thing?"
Manny Gonzalez asked.
"Of course,"
George told him.
"Did the tornado look real?" Jeremy asked.
"Totally," George nodded.
Just then, Mrs. Dirkman stood up and walked to the front of the room.
"Thank you for that report," she told George. "If any of you have more questions for George or Kevin, you can ask them at lunch. Right now, please take out your math workbooks."
Katie was glad that Mrs. Dirkman had changed the subject. Katie didn't like scary movies. She was especially afraid of big winds, like the kind they showed in Tornado. There was a good reason for that. Katie had been swept up in big winds herself, twice. And both times, her life had really changed. It had all started on a day when Katie was so sad that she'd wished she could be anyone but herself. There must have been a shooting star in the sky at the time, because Katie's wish came true. The next thing she knew, a big, strong, magic wind was blowing all around her. When the wind stopped, Katie had been turned into Speedy, the class hamster. Katie changed back into herself pretty fast, but the magic wind wasn't through with her. A couple of days later, it blew again, turning Katie into Lucille, the lunch lady in the cafeteria. Talk about awful. She'd had to serve disgusting cafeteria food. It had been a few weeks since that last disaster, but Katie was convinced the magic wind would be back.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.